reeks of League Cup to me, mate, and I don't like it. Neutral venues, you're absolutely right. They shouldn't be doing that. They did the Wembley thing because they wanted as many games there as possible to pay off that new stadium, didn't they?
Yep.
So
again, money.
Of course it is. And I completely agree with you. But the whole point of a neutral venue is, you know, that like Villa Park used to get used quite a lot because it's in Midlands and it's, you know, it's finding a ground in between two fans and it's as neutral as possible.
All right then, okay, I'll compromise a little bit. One leg, neutral ground, on a weekend night.
Yeah.
Quarter to eight Saturday night, 8 o'clock Saturday night at a neutral venue, not Liverpool fans or Newcastle fans travelling all the way down to Wembley.
No, I mean that's...
If it was, I don't know, Liverpool, Newcastle, could you use Old Trafford or Etihad? Is that
you could use Elland Road. You
know, Elland Road,
stuff like that.
A neutral ground, get rid of this daytime game on a Saturday, because the semi-finals are at 5 o'clock anyway now, aren't they?
They're all at 5 o'clock, it's
strange,
a normal time, isn't it?
Time to play a football game. So, we'll compromise then, we'll keep it one leg, get rid of Wembley, neutral venue.
Yeah.
Night time.
Yeah,
Saturday.
That's fine by me. Two leg, mate. I can't know.
All right.
No, I'm
compromised a little bit.
Yeah.
But that, to me now, actually thinking about it, makes more sense.
Yeah.
But under the lights, make
it
dark.
There's no reason why they can't. They could do a Saturday night and a Sunday night, you know, like just one day after each other. There's ways around it. A week after each other, whatever.
Yeah.
Because it's in the middle of calendar, so it's not going to affect much. So.
Yeah. So that's point number four. This is my biggest point of the lot, and it's point number five, and it is my biggest point, and it's one that I'm passionate about. Talk about Champions League. Talk about how Champions League has continuously... Think about the format of the Champions League when it first came to fruition, when it was just a European Cup, and how it's changed. And there was a point where they did the two group stages, and then moved it back to one because it didn't work. They're constantly revamping that competition to keep it at the best, which I think it is. One of the biggest changes that they made for me, which when they first did it, I was like, all right, okay, we'll see what happens with that. Saturday night, good. They moved the Champions League final from a Wednesday night to a Saturday night, which to me, now, in hindsight, makes complete sense. I want to talk about the FA Cup and the FA and what the FA should be doing to modernise this trophy. When we think back to our days as watching FA Cup, think about the Saturday football, think about the FA Cup final day, think about turning it on at 12 o'clock, watching all that build-up for 3 hours before the game kicks off at three. It was phenomenal. It was a full-day affair, the FA Cup.
Well, it was a novelty, but that's why people... Because now they do that for every single game out there anyway. But
the big move then was for me... Is that my phone or yours? That's rattling like mad.
It's not mine.
It must be mine. The big move for me was taking it to this stupid 5 o'clock kickoff. What's it all about? It's such a weird time to play a football game. It's just, I don't know. It's like here and there. It's like, I just don't know what it is. I don't get it. It's not light. It's not dark. It's the atmosphere is weird because the lighting's weird. It's just weird.
Do you know the massive problem with that as well? The transport wise. I went to, well, I didn't go in the end. Villa got to a FA Cup semi-final in 2010. I bought the ticket for it, but realised I couldn't get... that's when I was starting to lose a bit of interest, but I didn't want to drive down. I like getting... I've been to Wembley a few times, love going on train, just training underground, that's brilliant, I love it. But because of the 5 o'clock kickoff, I could not get a train back from King's Cross to Doncaster. And that's... I mean, anyone up north, really, would have been screwed that day. So it's... Yeah, why would you do that? Why would you not make it easy for the fans?
Well, this could probably maybe turn out to be a problem in what I'm saying, but this all comes back to Wembley, and should it have been built back at Wembley? When they said they were going to change the infrastructure and help it be more accessible, which I don't think it is, the kickoff time, you can't go back to 3 o'clock for me. You can't go back to that. We've done that. We're not about moving it on, we're about modernising it. There needs to be a massive event, a massive party, a massive spectacle, like they do with the Champions League. For me, quarter to eight, 8 o'clock kickoff, Saturday night at Wembley, under the lights, shut the roof if you want, make it dark.
Well, I suppose you've been more certain then, aren't you? So then people know they have to stop over.
Stick
on more trains.
Exactly.
It's not that hard. The underground goes right till midnight, 1 o'clock.
Think about Wembley finals a minute. Part of it is, the afterward, winning it. It's just, you look at the celebration, just like, what is that? There's nothing there. Think about Liverpool's Champions League winner was the most recent winner, or think about any Champions League winner on a Saturday night, well, any night, under the lights, celebrating it, fireworks going off, loads of celebration on the pitch, people going mad, it's night time. That's all gone.
This the celebration thing is exactly what you said before, the fact that the big clubs... I mean, who last non-top six side to win FA Cup? Wigan.
Wigan, 2013. Yeah.
And look, they celebrated.
Yeah.
But because it meant more to them.
But, yeah, I get that. But maybe that's because the top teams don't view it as a big final anymore. Maybe maybe partly that's because of all the drama getting there. Maybe that's because of when they get there, we're back at Wembley, we were here 4 weeks ago, having to play it out then, so it's not a big deal for me to walk on the Wembley pitch. You know, if you're a Burnley, right, and you made it to the final, and you're a Burnley player, you never played at Wembley before, but you have now because you played there in the semi-final, so that occasion isn't as big as what it once was, because you've been there, it's the same thing really, except it's a final now, it's just named differently, same fans, same stadium, doing the same thing. This is the lead up to it, this is trying to gain that interest in it, build it up, getting more fans, which is, ditch the VAR because people hate it, getting more fans in the seats by altering your ticket prices or giving away tickets for free, scrapping replays, no more Wembley semi-final. This is all, for me, building up to people then starting to take more interest in the FA Cup and move the flaming time. Get it under the lights, get it in the night time. When they've won, make it a massive spectacle that you won the FA Cup. Mm. Set fireworks off. Do what they do in the Champions League. Get the music playing. Get it just going mental under the lights. Play the music loud. Get the crowd involved. There is nothing. The 5 o'clock time, for me, has got to have been moved because it makes sense for some TV company to play it at 5 rather than play it at 3.
Yeah.
You know? But I tell you, the big opposition to this will be moving it to that time for normal terrestrial TV companies, because... they won't want FA Cup final on a Saturday night. That is their prime time slot. They'd rather have Anton Deck's takeaway on.
Yeah, yeah.
But that is if so. If, let me tell you something about this. If the BBC and the ITV can't provide the time that we want for that final to make the FA Cup, give it the magic that it once had, get rid of them. Unfortunately, at this moment in time, your best alternative is Sky or BT, because they will put it at 7:45 on a Saturday night, because that will be... They don't get figures like that on a Saturday night for anything else.
Yeah, well, that's what their channel's about.
Make
isn't it?
A massive spectacle. Revamp the presenting of it. Get them down on the pitch like another Champions League. Get them interacting more. Give it the big lick of paint that it needs.
Gary Lineker, are you listening?
Well, yeah, seriously. But for me, I just don't know why they're not modernising it. I just do not know, in my heart of hearts, why they're not looking into these changes and doing it. If you want the FA Cup around in 10, 15, 20 years' time, when me and my lad or my little girl wants to be talking about, oh, Dad, can you remember when this happened in the FA Cup or that final? Mm. We're not going to get there at the minute because nobody's bothered about turning it on at 5 o'clock on a flaming afternoon on Saturday. It's ridiculous.
I must say, I'm 4.5 out of 5 on your points.
See?
I've still got a little bit of problem with replays, but everything else, mate, I quite agree with you. It's a good case.
Yeah, I just think all of them put together... We kind of changed the replays a little, haven't we? Oh no, we didn't. No. Sorry. What, you want to keep the replays, didn't you?
Well, I do, but if you don't, you have to have extra time. I'm not having that.
I never said not extra time. Yeah. To me, it was always the case. I didn't mean just go straight to penalty. Give them another 30.
They're doing League Cup though, don't they? That's the problem with that.
I mean that really is dead.
Yeah,
the League Cup. And like I say, my idea to revamp the League Cup, maybe I'll talk about that next week, which I think is another good one. You've got to modernise these things. Mm. Champions League modernises. The Premier League modernised the old First Division. It did. It made it, I don't know if you could argue...
Marketable.
Marketable. But it's got more interest, not just in this country, because it's always an interest here, globally. Mm. It's a big deal. It's a big event. Winning the league's a massive... I'm not saying it wasn't a massive event before, but even normal people now, who maybe not into football, say, oh, you know, Premier League, there is prick up a little bit more. Champions League's a big deal. It's a massive deal. FA Cup used to be a big deal. The reason why it's not a big deal anymore is because the dinosaurs that run it have not modernised it to the modern day. Mm. To bring it up, change the times, stop doing stupid replays, scrap VAR, lower the prices, get more fans, get people back in love with the FA Cup.
Yeah,
you know, it's important. It's really, really, really important. And there's our time.
No, it's cut you off.
So that is my 5-point plan of saving the FA Cup. Get in touch, leave me some feedback.
Yeah, I think once this is up, you need to post this 5-point plan as well.
But in neater writing than that.
Well, get it on the pages and so people can actually see it in writing.
Yeah,
you never know, mate. You might get someone seeing it.
Yeah, maybe we should forward it to Gary Lineker, see what he says. But yeah, that is my 5-point plan. We're going to have a little bit of half-time entertainment. I can't remember what to say. In terms of getting back to us, I never remember.
Twitter, at Soccer Shed.
Yeah.
And the Facebook page is The Soccer Shed.
Facebook page is The Soccer Shed.
Yeah.
And we're all over podcast now. We're up on everything now.
Yeah.
You remember all these.
Apple, Google, Spotify.
Deezer.
Podchaser. And we'll be sorting out the pod follow thing soon. And also, it's easier for your phone. As soon as you click on it, it sends it to what's the best for your mobile as well.
We'll talk more about that next week. So we're going to have a look into that this afternoon, aren't we? Go again, that sorted out. So we've got some half-time entertainment. Make sure you stick around, because when we come back, Mr. Steelyard is going to be talking us through...
English strikers in the 1990s, mate.
As if that's not enough to make you stick around. Before that, still a little bit about half-time entertainment. And then we shall be back. Do not go anywhere right now, and come back and we'll talk about these English strikers. The Soccer Shed is proudly sponsored by I Am The Renovation, footwear customization and restoration specialists. Check out the work they do on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter at I Am The Renovation. Inbox them for any football custom ideas. They do lots of fantastic retro music themes and much, much more. They will customise trainers to your requests, and they are also up there with the very best when it comes to restoration work. I am The Renovation.